Gabe, you've been charged with intoxicating yourself with intoxicants. You've already spent some time in jail. We're here. We need a plea from you. We need to find out if you're going to go ahead and have an attorney represent you so we can go ahead and move business along. Now, do you want to spend more time in jail, or are you going to go ahead and finally cooperate?
I'm going to plead guilty right now.
All right. Now we're going to go ahead. We're going to set a trial date. Well, actually, before the trial date, are you going to represent yourself, or are you taking the court discretion on getting yourself an attorney? Because obviously you can't represent yourself, based on your last transcript that I read. But, you know, I'm still offering the same courtesy that the court has for every person that's been in the same shoes that you are. You are hereby able to be representative of yourself, which I highly advise against. Not giving legal advice, just simply saying that you might want to have an attorney on your side. But then again, these are your choices alone. I cannot make them for you. I just need to make sure that you are competent and can go ahead and enter a plea. So you've already pled guilty.
No, I intend on pleading guilty here today. I just had a few quick clarifications.
We're not going to go through this again. We've already clarified what you're charged with. You've spent some time in jail, and we need to get this moving on. We can't take any more of the time up. I know you really don't want to have any more time that's going against you. We have business to handle today, and we need to get to the business. So will you be represented by an attorney, or will you be representing yourself?
I'm here to handle business. This is my business suit. This is my business tie. I'm here for business.
Okay, great. Glad you're here for business. So will you be proceeding on your own or with an attorney?
Well, I was just wondering, do I have the right to make an informed plea of guilty today? I would like to get this over with today.
Well, I believe from the record you have already entered a plea. We just need to simply find out if you're proceeding with an attorney or if you're going pro se on your own. You've already been advised of the risks, and we honestly just do not have time to continue leisuring you at our expense. So please do not take any more of the court's time, and you will not have to spend any more time incarcerated, which I don't believe was a pleasant time for you.
Just to clarify, are you telling me that you can accept a plea that is uninformed and involuntary?
Well, the pleas that we will accept is guilty, not guilty, or no contest, and it will be coming voluntarily from you. Of course, we need to make sure that we get this plea in so we know how we're going to proceed here today, Mr. Bryant. We need to continue. We need to get this moving. I need to know, are you going with a lawyer or without a lawyer? Because you have already entered a plea of not guilty, and obviously you're going to trial.
I didn't enter that plea, but that wasn't really responsive to what I asked.
Asked if did you not enter a plea on April, the last hearing that we were with? I believe Judge so-and-so before I had to take over matters. He had some personal business he had to take care of. But you did enter a plea at your last hearing from my records that I'm showing. Is that correct?
I don't know if that's entirely correct. Because
what do you mean it's not correct?
Coerced. Is a judge permitted to coerce a plea or to accept a plea that is uninformed and involuntary?
Well, that's what we're here to do today, is to accept a plea and find out exactly how you're trying to proceed from here. Mr. Bryant, we are trying to help you as best as possible, but I am not your lawyer, nor am I representing you. We need to move this along and make sure that you are well within your rights to do what you need. But I need your decision before we continue, if you're continuing without a lawyer or if you will be representing yourself.
I have to object. You know, if you would just
give me
a simple yes or no, then we would have already been out of here and done with this.
Yes, you have a right to plea here today. That's what I'm trying to find. I'm trying to find if you're the trial or if you're pleading guilty.
Do I have the right to make an informed and voluntary plea?
Well, any plea you enter will be voluntarily, and you've already been informed of the charges that are here to you. Do you need me to read them again?
That's not the question I'm... Or that's not relevant to what I'm asking.
It's not your opinion to determine what's relevant or not. All that's relevant right now is, are you proceeding with or without an attorney, Mr. Bryan?
I'm not interested in attorney at this time.
All right, so you're continuing without an attorney. So you will be representing yourself.
Objection.
We will then continue.
Objection. Did I say I was representing myself?
You said you did not want an attorney. If you say you do not want an attorney, I will mark down that you do not want an attorney and that you will be representing yourself. Is that correct?
I object to that.
Well, then please tell me, how do you want
to
proceed?
Counsel at a later date.
So you want to seek counsel. So you're going to go ahead and you're going to seek counsel.
Nope.
We will schedule this hearing for a later date.
Objection. I reserve the right to seek counsel at a later date.
Okay, so do you want to continue on your own or with an attorney?
Objection. Do I have the right to get clarifications without interruption?
It's about damn time, for fuck's sake.
God damn, about damn time. I don't understand what you mean.
Again, that's not responsive to the question I asked. If you solely want to interrupt me and try to coerce a plea, then
okay,
I'd rather.
Okay, look,
you
I'm
just...
sorry, but I'm trying to get my point across. I'm trying to find out exactly what you're trying to do here, how you want to proceed, whether you want to proceed with an attorney or not, Mr. Bryan. I'm really trying to hold my patience with you, but you're trying the court's patience. It's unfortunate that we are doing our best to inform you, but if you wish to continue on your own, plead not guilty, we will go ahead and get you an attorney. You can pay for one, or we will assign you one if needed, and then we can continue from there. But if you want to continue, I need to know if you want to continue on your own, so we can get official business in, or if you're going to continue the shenanigans with the court. So how do you want to proceed, with or without an attorney?
I object. And again, I intend to plead guilty here today, as I've already said.
I know
said.
Your intention to plead guilty here is today. We understand
objection.
What your intention is, but my intention is to find out from you what you want to do, with or without an attorney. What is it? Mr. Bryan, did
I
you
object
hear me?
To that? Do I
object to what? What are you objecting to? There's no reason to object to this. We're just simply trying to find out how you want to proceed. Are you objecting to proceeding? Because I can't have you objecting to proceeding. That is not cooperating with the court, and that is very definite grounds to hold you in contempt again if needed.
I object to that as well. And I'll thank you to not threaten me. So do I have the right to enter an informed and voluntary plea here today?
Your plea to be voluntarily entered, yes. And I've already informed you of the charges that you are faced. You are here under the charge of being intoxicated by alcohol, and you have multiple different times charges that you're facing. And this just really doesn't look good. You already have one contempt. You've been in jail for, you know, that's paper somewhere right here. But you've already been held in contempt. Do you want to be held in contempt again? I'm trying to be the fairest judge that I possibly can. But you just don't seem to be wanting to cooperate with the system. And we need to move on with business. Mr. Bryant, I will ask you again, how do you want to proceed?
You keep saying that you've informed me. Is that an arbitrary opinion, or is it based on facts currently within your knowledge?
It's based on facts. You are charged with the... I'm looking at the citation that the officer has charged you with right here. And you were publicly intoxicated driving a motor vehicle in this state. That's grounds for... That's breaking the law, allegedly. Now we're just simply trying to see... how you want to proceed with this.
So I'm going to write that down. Give me just a second. The judge says I've been informed and it's based on facts. Okay, so what facts do you have that I've been informed?
Do you have a copy of the citation? you have been read the allegation and the charges of the complaint that has been before you. You have been in this court beforehand with another judge presenting your trial or your statements, and you are unwillfully cooperating or unwillfully participating against the system, and this cannot continue any further. You need to let us know how to continue. Otherwise, we will make that decision for you. And then we have all the means, if you're not cooperating, to put the decision in for you. It's of your own best interest, because obviously you want to fight this. And it's not that you can fight it here in front of me. No, you're not going to fight it in front of me. Like, I'm not the one you're fighting it in front of. You have the right to a jury trial, you have the right for a bench trial, and you have the right to an attorney. Now I need to know, will you take your right to attorney or not?
Objection. Are you telling me that that's all the information that I'm allowed to have is a copy of the ticket?
No, I'm sorry. You have one final chance. Your games with this court are not being tolerated, and I've tried to be as nice as possible to you. I need to know how you're going to proceed. We already have your intent. You want to plead guilty. You don't want to plead guilty. We can't keep going in circles. Do you want to proceed with a lawyer, or are you pleading guilty?
Well, how can I get counsel if I am not allowed to?
Do you
want to
fight this,
informed?
Yes or no? Mr. Bryan, are you trying to fight this charge against? Are you trying to fight these allegations, or do you want to plead guilty here today?
Have I not made clear my intention to plead guilty?
Yes, you've already made your intent clear. You have already made your pretense clear that you do not want to comply with this court. Bailiff, I am now imposing a contempt of 42 hours to be held out immediately. Mr. Bryant, you take your time to go ahead and get what you need. We will enter.
Objection. Point of clarification.
You have already had your objections. I am sorry, but it is clear to this court that you are not competent to go ahead and continue on your own. You failed to follow the procedures that are stated out in front of you within this court has a jurisdiction to go ahead and follow the proceedings that you are irregularly trying to obtain are not within this proper court procedure. And I hereby find you in contempt to serve the sentence immediately. Thank you. You're in jail, bitch.
You kept on bringing up number one, never number two or three.
All right, so we just got done with the role play.
What up, Gabe?
What up? Yeah, that was good, Ginger.
So what do you got on your tactics or your thoughts?
Yeah, I should have definitely been using the two and three as well. Yeah, I was trying to get him to answer the damn question, the clarification.
And why wasn't he?
But he's a judge, yo. Judges are OG.
We just have to be sneaky skillful about it, as opposed to fucking bull in a china shop. So, what could you have done that would have been more OG?
I'm not sure. Use the two and three more and...
What I would say is that at some point you need to just switch gears, realize you're on a dead end for that track, and maybe back out a few steps on that same track. The absolute least you need to do at some point is word the same question completely differently.
All right, so your abilities with a judge who's just going to run you over and talk a bunch and interrupt you to no end need work, right? So what are some things that you could do? And I don't know, I'm just wondering why you didn't do those things. You know, I mean, it was all down his path. And I didn't hear any attempts to bring it back to yours and address the bullying. Is that something that you, I don't know, have some kind of a default button against or?
Yes and no. I mean, yeah, I definitely should have brought it up and addressed the bullying and the rush to judgment, but yeah, I guess I just didn't think about it.
It's kind of like, you know, a UFC fight. You're only as good as your last performance. And that's scary, dude, if you're letting a guy, judge, whatever, kind of walk over you verbally like that without putting a magnifying glass on his tactics. He's not even letting you think, let alone speak. Is that in any way a fair hearing? I mean, we have counter tactics to this right. shit. You know, that we've mentioned there's nothing wrong with, because I want to hear everything you're saying, and I want to make sure that I respond honestly to your questions. So I need you to slow down when you speak, and may I have a moment to collect my thoughts. Anything, you know, to break this momentum. Because it's like a team, basketball team, you know, they're like on a 12-point streak, and you're not calling a timeout. So there's it's calling a timeout, and then any of the 1, 2, 3 to bring it back to the element of jurisdiction. I mean, even if it doesn't make any sense, and it's a total right out in the open, bring it back to jurisdiction. And, you know, he's going to either have to address it or blow it off. But either way, you win. Because you can bring up why he's refusing to even go there.
Let me put it to you this way. I was using some of the same stuff that I listened today with that shitty judge that recused himself over his confrontation with you. And it kind of went how the video went with the steamrolling, and you didn't come back against that. But that's pretty much all I was basing my reactions and statements off of yours was the video that Joe, and that's all I pretty much used on you, and you still didn't break through it. So that was my process as a judge just now.
Even if he was a little far, it was totally within the aggression limits. Even if some of his words weren't words that a judge would use, most of them were. And I just don't even have a problem letting it slide anyway, just because it's working on you, number one, and it's not too far off from reality, number two. It's good for everybody to hear. We're not just trying to, let's beat up Gabe because he had a shitty performance. It's not like that. So let's just, I don't know. We've identified the problem. So what do you got for solutions? Be direct. When this happens again, I'll try and focus on this, this, and this. I don't want to just hear the right words come out of your mouth. I want you to make me believe that you're getting something out of this, and that if you had to go to court tomorrow with the same kind of asshole, you'd do a hell of a lot better than you just did. Because I think you just got caught with like a deer in the headlights. You know? Right. And once it was going downhill, you were kind of resigned to the fact that this is going downhill, not down my track. I mean, are you not bringing your A game? And maybe part of the problem is you, and this is totally, you know, this happens. This is common. I mean, I do it. Everybody does it to some degree. Are you not bringing your A game into these role plays? Is it kind of like, this is a B game environment? Because there's that.
No.
I
think you guys started off like kind of messing around, and then it just kept on going. And I don't know. Maybe you didn't start off the right way.
Okay. So, yeah, what suggestions do you have, Ginger?
My suggestion to you? Go listen to that video of you getting your ass kicked in the courtroom, and go listen to it 100 times over until you get the feeling in your chest to where you're like, I will never be like that again, because there is so many tactics and stuff that the judge is trying to farm for in yours to try to see how he's going to go ahead and get it to throw you in jail. So I think that there's quite a few tactics that I learned off of those videos today, which kind of helped give me the best asset against you. Go watch those videos, listen to your stuff again, listen to Joe's actual commentary on it, and you might find something that's eye-opening for you. From all of this that I hear everyone saying, you want it on your path. At some point where you're down his road and you realize you've been down his road for a while and you're just being reactive to whatever statement he's doing, remember, get proactive, as Joe said. Proactiveness is what creates winners. So you have to get him back on your track. The moment that you see that you're off, follow him a couple steps if you need to, but make sure that you're get back on your path.
Well, just because they mentioned the word contempt doesn't mean we've lost. It just means they're trying to be sneaky and threaten you, or they really do have intentions to put you in jail, but I think a contempt charge by a judge is, at least outside of the psychotic ones, is something they wouldn't prefer. Because we're never, you know, like, fuck this place and taking a swing at the prosecutor. We're never doing that shit. So it's never, like, blatantly justified.